Welcome to the orientation for the NECA IBEW Electrical Training Center. We are going to cover the apprenticeship programs that we offer, including the basic overview of each program, when to apply, how to apply, and what you should provide to us when you do apply. We will go over the application process, from turning in your application all the way through getting an interview, getting placed on the list, and what it takes to become an apprentice. This is our website found at www.nietc.org. There is a lot of good information on here, and we update it regularly. The location on this website that is most pertinent to you is this tab that says Applications, How to Apply. You can click on the Apprenticeship Programs tab in the drop-down menu and find information about whichever program you are interested in. There is also information about the application process and some valuable tips for preparing your application. All of our programs are sponsored by two organizations, NECA, which is the National Electrical Contractors Association, and IBEW Local 48, which is the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers. All of our contractors are members of NECA, and all of the electricians and apprentices that they hire are union members through IBEW Local 48. We are privately funded through our own resources. This is a private school. We are affiliated with Mount Hood Community College. All of the classes that you take as an apprentice are registered with Mount Hood as non-credit classes. After you graduate the program, if you choose, you can take some additional classes at Mount Hood Community College to earn your associate's degree in applied science. This is our agreement with the community college. You become a student at the community college, so you have access to their resources as well. We are an equal opportunity employer. We do a lot to encourage women and minorities in the trades. There are a few organizations that we work with a lot. One is the Electrical Workers Minority Caucus. They meet monthly and can be found at this website. Oregon Tradeswomen, as well as Women of Local 48, are two groups that provide mentoring and support to women in the trades. We here at the Training Center are here to help. Should you choose assistance, we are here to provide it. We have a pretty large geographical area. When you are an apprentice in our programs, you are going to obligate yourself to work anywhere in our jurisdiction. We have an agreement with our contractors. If they bid work anywhere in this geographic area, they agree to hire IBEW Local 48 members. Likewise, we as IBEW Local 48 agree to show up and wire the building, wind tower, highway, whatever the job may be. While much of our work is in the Portland and Vancouver area, you have to be willing to go where the work is. This can be a difficult situation sometimes for apprentices. This may cause some inconveniences, whether it means missing your kids' sports games or other events. As a journeyman, you have the ability to turn down work, but as an apprentice, you have to be committed to go where you are needed. We have three different programs, and each involves on-the-job training and classroom instruction. You may apply for more than one program, but we do encourage you to pick the one that fits your aptitude and interests best. Once accepted into the apprenticeship, you will be placed with an electrical contractor for your on-the-job training. The Inside Electrician Program is a 5-year program, also known as the Commercial Industrial Program. The program requires completion of 8,000 hours of on-the-job training and 10 terms of school. This program licenses you to do any electrical work on the customer side of the utility point of connection. Inside electricians can do all of the wiring on that property, and there is a broad variety of electrical work. This license covers the scope of all the other licenses that we train for. You could be wiring residences, commercial buildings, hospitals, traffic signals, industrial facilities, limited energy systems, as well as systems in the growing fields of solar and wind. The limited energy technician is a 3.5-year program and involves 6,000 on-the-job training hours and 7 terms of school. It is also known as the low voltage program. Limited energy techs work on sound and communication systems that are 100 volts or less, such as fiber optic, voice and data, nurse call, controls, fire alarm, and security. The limited residential program is a 2.5-year program comprised of 4,000 hours of on-the-job training and 5 terms of school. This program covers residences up to 3 stories above grade. This does not cover a high-rise apartment or condo building downtown. That would fall under the inside electrician's scope of work. It does cover all systems within the home: lighting and receptacles, appliances, voice and data, fiber optics, security, etc. This is our smallest program. We do not have a lot of work in the residential market, so the wait list for this program moves pretty slowly. We do have a residential to inside upgrade program, so if you carry a residential electrician license, there is a path to upgrade your license to a commercial license. You will need to work 2 years as a residential journeyman and complete 2 terms of school on your own here at the training center. You will then need to apply for and get accepted into the inside program. Upon acceptance, you will be given 4,000 hours of credit when placed in that program. We created a video that highlights some of our apprentices working on the job. They talk about some of the challenges that you can expect to face as an apprentice.
I typically wake up at 5 a.m. So I have enough time to eat breakfast in the morning, get my tools ready, make sure I have everything I need for the day, and then I like to get to work about a half hour early. Start time 6:30, and we do stretch and flex for 10 minutes. Then I'll go around to every journeyman and ask if they need anything for the day, and I'll run get materials for them.
We're at the Columbia Boulevard Wastewater Treatment Plant, and I am running PVC-coated rigid. We're putting that in, just bending pipe most all day, every day, and I've been here for 7 months.
I'm working out at Bull Run.
We're pulling in inner duct for some fiber optic runs for this weather station.
Today we are downtown Portland. We are doing a remodel. There are a lot of hard physical working conditions. People look at us and they'll see us doing the final part. They don't see the days that we're involved in installing pipe, bending pipe. There's just tons and tons of prep work before you pull the wire.
We've been working with 4-inch rigid pipe. They're electrical pipes and they weigh about 110 pounds a piece. When you're lifting it up off the ground and on your shoulder up and down every day, it's a workout. I want to be able to do all aspects of electrical work. So getting in a ditch or, you know, installing heavy pipe is something I want to learn.
Yesterday we were digging and we ran into concrete and I swung a sledgehammer for about 3 hours and ran a chipper. I didn't feel very much like an electrician, but it was quite tiring. I mean, there's always carrying material, things are heavy. There's more physical work than I had thought.
We did the lights on the airport runway. We're mud up to our knees for probably about 3 months every day. I mean, mud's so thick that when you step in it, and you try to lift your foot up out of the mud, your boot actually stays in the mud. I just say to myself, you know, we're gonna get this done. All these other guys are out here, everyone's doing it. You know, I wanna be someone that everyone knows they can depend on. That's important to me.
You do everything you can just to keep your attitude good, because work is what it is and you've gotta make the most out of it. Started here during the summer, which it was hot. It was about 100 degrees. Then we switched into fall. So now it's been rainy, it's been icy, it's been snowy. You just layer up and you try to keep your gloves dry. You have to make the best out of your day.
It's not just physically hard. The schooling's hard to get through. We go to a class every week and then I'm spending hours, you know, outside of school studying to get through those classes. We're all working, you know, as an apprentice for the next 5 years to know how to be a good electrician with your hands, and then you got to take a test, you know, after the 5 years. So, I mean, it's a kind of a balance between studying and working hard.
There's a lot of time involved: homework at school, come to the job. I happen to have 2 kids at home, so balancing all that together, it becomes overwhelming sometimes.
In general, the hardest thing about being an apprentice is learning the communication styles of everybody that you're working with.
Being able to do things their way and still figure out what's going to work best for you and get things done in the most efficient way possible.
You're taking orders from everyone on your crew pretty much.
You have to be able to step back and listen to what everybody else has to say to you, which for some people is difficult.
We as apprentices, we have to adapt and pick up the lingo and learn their communication style.
When you finish running your pipe run and it, you know, to me it looks beautiful. You get done, you pull the wire and you make some motors turn.
I like being an electrician because I'm proud to say I am an electrician to people. My son thinks it's really cool. It's just, there's lots of benefits to it, and I know I can do this for the rest of my life and be taken care of. So.
Attend an orientation the third Tuesday of each month from 4 to 5 p.m. at the training center. Go to NIETC.org to learn more.
Current journeyman wages for the three licenses, as well as wages you will be paid as an apprentice, can be found on our website, www.nietc.org. You can see that the wages are related to the length of the program. Wage progression is similar for all the programs. The inside program starts apprentices off at 40% of journeyman rate. They then get a 5 to 10% increase after every 1,000 or 1,500 hours of on-the-job training. The limited energy program is similar. It starts out at 50% of journeyman rate, with wage increases about every 750 hours. The limited residential program starts out at 55% of journeyman rate, with a wage increase every 750 hours. We are a drug-free industry, and you will be drug tested throughout your career. Pre-employment. When you come into the program as a new apprentice, you will take a pre-employment drug test. If you fail that drug test, you are automatically removed from the program. If you still want to become an electrician, you need to start all over. We have random drug testing. This applies to the entire industry. Project estimators, foremen, superintendents, office staff, anyone who works for an electrical contractor or IBEW. This is done on a random basis, once, twice, three times a year. Within the first year of your apprenticeship, if you fail a drug test, you are automatically removed from the program. We also have for-cause drug testing. If you are involved in an on-the-job accident or injury, you will be drug tested. Marijuana is not permitted, and you can fail a drug test for having taken someone else's prescription drugs. We do background checks. When you apply for the program, there will be a question on the application, "Have you ever been convicted of a felony?" You need to be forthright if you have been. Describe the felony and provide information. When you interview, they will ask questions and document your answers. Once you get accepted into the program, we are going to compare your application with what we get back on the background check and make sure that you were truthful. It is important that you know to be honest at your interview. Once you are accepted into the program, we do not use your background information for anything other than determining job assignments. When an employer calls and requests an apprentice, they will tell us the job site. That job site might be a school, or the airport, or some other job site that requires a background check with no felonies. If you are the next available apprentice, the first thing we do is verify that you meet any security clearance criteria. If you do not, then we won't send you to that job. We will go to the next apprentice on the list. We use this to make sure that you meet the employability requirement. We don't share the information with anyone. It prevents embarrassment and issues to you on the job if you are sent to a job site and then fail the background check. Credit for prior experience may be granted. You may not necessarily get hour-for-hour credit. It is up to you to request a performance evaluation and review after you pass your aptitude test. Otherwise, your wages and class placement will be based upon assumption of zero experience. This is the application process for apprenticeship. You will come in to fill out an application in person during an open application period. The application is 2 pages long and must be filled out on site. You can find application openings and times at our website. For the inside program and limited energy program, if you qualify, you will take an aptitude test the following month. If you pass the aptitude test, you will be scheduled for an interview the month after that. For the limited residential program, if you qualify, you will move straight to the interview. No aptitude test is required. After your interview, you will be placed on the ranked list of eligible candidates. Once we have jobs available, We will pull from that list, beginning with one in ascending order, and place you in a new class to start basic skills training. View tips for successful completion of the application process at the Preparing to Apply section of www.nietc.org. To qualify for the Inside Electrician and Limited Energy Technician programs, you need to meet the GED or GPA requirement, as well as the math requirement. You need to be either a high school or college graduate from an accredited school with a minimum of a 2.0 GPA verified by transcripts, or have a GED with the minimum score shown on the following slide. This slide lists the qualifying GED score necessary for meeting the requirement for the Inside and Limited Energy programs. These are the ways in which you can meet the math requirement for the Inside Electrician and Limited Energy Technician programs. To qualify for the Limited Residential Electrician program, you need to show transcripts proving that you are a high school or college graduate or have a GED with a minimum score shown here. These are the ways in which you can meet the math requirement for the Limited Residential Electrician program. If you do not meet the math requirement, you can take this online tech math class, pass the class, and turn in the certificate with your application, and that will satisfy the math requirement. You still need to show that you meet the high school or GED requirements. This class is good for several reasons. First, it satisfies the math requirement. Second, it is a good review for the algebra portion of the aptitude test. And third, the class will help you build a strong foundation in math, which will help you succeed in the program, which is heavily math-driven. The class starts off with whole numbers and is self-paced as it advances through Boolean algebra fundamentals. Be sure to leave yourself time to complete the class before the application opening closes. It does take some time to enroll in the class, as they need to mail you a textbook and a calculator. This is another website that may help you to prepare for the application process. When you come in to apply, you will need photo ID. There is an application fee of $30 for the Inside Electrician and Limited Energy programs. You can apply for a fee waiver if your income is below 150% of the federal poverty guidelines, or you can just show us a SNAP, Oregon Trail, or basic food card. You need to bring all supporting documentation showing that you meet the requirements at the time that you apply. You may also decide to turn in a cover letter, resume, and letters of recommendation, as well as anything else that shows your qualifications, such as photos of projects, technical certificates, or a military DD-214. While these are not required, they will be favorable with the interview committee. Ideally, when you apply, you will submit all of these supplemental things at that time, and this will show that you are organized and thorough. At the interview, you may bring anything additional that you have done since the time that you applied. Do not mail anything into the training center. You need to apply in person and fill out the application on site and attach documentation proving that you met the requirements. You may not send in additional information once you have turned in your application, but you may bring it to your interview. If you are reapplying, please note that if you would like the interview committee to consider supplemental documentation in their scoring of your qualifications, you will need to submit another set. The front office will only forward transcripts to your new application. If you are applying in the summer months, please take into account that many schools are closed and you may need to leave yourself more time to contact the school district for your transcripts. If your school is no longer in existence, then you will need to contact that school district and try to get a copy of your transcript. If you are unable, then you will have to take a GED test. You must meet all of the requirements at the time that you apply and provide that documentation. It is up to you to make sure that you meet all of these requirements and provide documentation. We are not going to chase that documentation down. If the documentation is not provided at the time of applying, your application will be closed and you will need to reapply. It is important that you understand what is required and make sure that you meet those requirements. If your transcript has math at a higher level than algebra, but does not reflect that you have completed a year of algebra with a C or better, your application will be closed. Often people take algebra in middle school, so their transcripts do not show algebra. The recommendation is to either take a math placement test and place into math 95 or higher, or take the tech math class. This standard is set by the national committee, and there are no exceptions made. Transcripts must be from an accredited school. If you were homeschooled, you will need to take a GED test and either a college placement test, college algebra class, or the tech math class and meet the requirements that way. If you have a foreign transcript, it must be translated by an accredited agency. The aptitude test is only required for the inside electrician and the limited energy programs. You will receive a sample test along with your testing date. There are two parts, reading comprehension and algebra. With reading comprehension, you read a paragraph about a topic that has nothing to do with electrical, and then you will answer 5 or 6 questions about it. It is a time test, 36 items in 51 minutes. The second part is algebra, and you are not allowed to use a calculator. You need to know how to manipulate algebraic formulas and equations, graphs and charts. There are 33 questions and 46 minutes allowed. You need to score at least a 5 out of a 9-point scale. In order to get a 5, you need to get a minimum score on both parts. You can't fail one part and score high on another. Tests are scored off-site at a testing agency. The training center receives back only the score, not the tests themselves. If you are applying for the limited residential program and have turned in a qualifying application, you will be scheduled for your interview. If you are applying for the inside electrician or limited energy technician program, have turned in a qualifying application, and have received a qualifying score on the aptitude test, you will be scheduled for an interview. The interview panel is made up of about 4 to 10 members from the contractors, the union, and the training center. They will look at everything you provided in your application. That is why it is important to provide an orderly application packet with a well-organized resume and any certificates that prove what you have earned. We will look at any past experience and education that you are bringing to the table. This is a competitive program. We know that everyone who qualifies for an interview has met the minimum requirements. These requirements are a minimum. So then we start measuring things like past experience and education. You will be scored on character and attitude, the way you dress and how you present yourself. The committee is looking for individuals who will represent NECA contractors and the IBEW. The general recommendation is nice pants, button-down shirt, and nice shoes. They are looking at your work experience. Is it related to construction or to electrical? If your work history is not trade-related, were you a good employee? Do you have lengthy employment history with one employer? Do you have letters of recommendation from your employer, and what are they saying about you in those letters? Letters from coworkers, friends, or family members are okay, but they are not great. Letters from supervisors are preferred, and they should be signed and on letterhead. A letter from an electrician is good, and a letter from an electrical contractor is the best. If they would be willing to hire you when you get into the program, that speaks volumes for you. We look at your education and training. If you took trade-related classes, if you have hands-on hobbies, or have volunteered with a construction-focused volunteer group like Habitat for Humanity. After you interview, you will receive a letter that tells you your rank. When we receive enough requests for new apprentices from our contractors to start a new class, we will pull from that ranked list of candidates, beginning with number 1. Everyone on the list will then move down the list by that number. So if we start a new class of 12, we will pull numbers 1 through 12 off the list, and everyone number 13 and up will move down 12 spaces. Your rank is also going to change whenever we interview more applicants, most likely moving up the list if people score and rank better than you. You can always contact the training center to find out where you are at on this list later on down the road. There is no way to look up your rank online. You will stay on the rank list for 2 years. You cannot reapply during that 2-year period, which is why it's critical that you don't rush in to apply until you are ready and can bring experience to the table. If you are unhappy with your rank, you may work on qualifying for a re-interview. Essentially, you improve your qualifications and return as a better candidate. This slide explains how to qualify for a re-interview. You would submit a re-interview request form and attach documentation that you have improved your qualifications in one of the two ways. Your request will be reviewed, and if it is accepted, you will be placed in the next group of interviewees. If you have worked the 1,000 hours in a trade-related field, it is a good idea to get a letter of recommendation from that employer. Re-interviews are not guaranteed. When the economy is slow, we will not conduct re-interviews. We bring in new apprentices based on the economy. We only bring in as many apprentices as we can employ on a close to full-time basis. We don't bring people in when we don't have a need. We try for 1 to 2 weeks notice at the very least. Most often it is 3 to 5 weeks. Correspondence is by mail, so please be sure to inform us of any changes to your address. If you don't respond to our letter inviting you to the next class, your application will be closed and you will be removed from the list. You will attend a basic skills class, and then you will be assigned to your employer. The basic skills class is 10 days long. It is still part of the application process. You have received a high ranking due to your paperwork and interview and have been accepted into a new class. Now you need to show us that you can perform the work of an electrical worker. The class involves safety training, aerial lift training, climbing ladders, using tools, and some electrical theory. We evaluate you throughout the class. During that 2 weeks, we want to be sure that you show up on time every day, ready to work, that you passed the drug test, that you were truthful on the background check. You may be removed from the program for a number of reasons, such as failing the drug screening, not being truthful about a felony, being late or unprepared for class, being absent, or lacking a mechanical aptitude or ability to comprehend the curriculum. We want to be sure that we are investing training in the very best applicants. We assign you to an employer whom you will go to work for at the end of the 2-week basic skills class. Generally, apprentices cannot be requested by name by a specific shop. If you currently work for an electrical contractor as a material handler and you make it through the basic skills class, we will make a courtesy call to the employer and inquire if they would like to hire you as an apprentice. If not, then we will assign you to another contractor. Approximately 3 months after starting work, we will schedule you for classes. This allows you to build up work hours so that your health benefits kick in. You will receive a letter in the mail with the day that you will be attending classes. It is part of your apprenticeship, so instead of going to work that day, you will come to school that day. The employers know this and expect this. When you are in class, you will be working 4 days a week and attending class 1 day a week. You must notify your employer of your schedule once you receive that letter. You do not get paid while you are in school, so that is something to consider when you are planning your budget. Ultimately, it's fair to expect that you'll only get paid 32 hours a week for half the year, provided that your employer is able to offer you that many hours. Most apprentices work full-time. However, due to the nature of construction and the economy, we cannot guarantee 40 hours of work a week, which is why we try to instill in our apprentices the importance of building a savings account for those times when work is not available. Apprentices receive an automatic scholarship for tuition, books, and tools. So essentially, school for you is free as long as you are a good student and a good employee. When you start the program, we provide you with about $500 worth of tools and several hundred dollars worth of books. As long as you are in good standing with school and work, then the scholarship is there for you. If you fail a class, then you need to retake the class at your own cost. We pay for your apprenticeship all the way through, and after you journey out, there is a repayment contract. This is a year-for-year contract, and it is how you repay us for the training that you received. The contract states that once you graduate, you will continue to work in the trade for a NECA contractor. That NECA contractor pays into the training fund for every hour that you work for them as a journeyman. This is how our training fund stays funded. So every year that you have worked for a contractor as a journeyman, you have repaid a year of your training. If you move to a different state after you graduate, as long as you are working for an IBEW contractor who is paying into that state's training fund, you will be in compliance. If you are applying for a 5-year program, it is essentially a 10-year commitment. If you choose to leave before repayment is complete, you may repay your scholarship, which is currently valued at $6,000 per year. We are not looking for people to pay us in cash for training. We are not in the business of selling education. We are trying to train our future workforce. What we want you to do is be a journeyman and a mentor, training the next wave of apprentices who are our future workforce. It is critical that you plan any vacations around your school schedule. You are allowed one absence from school per term, which must be made up on the one Saturday makeup class that is scheduled per term. There is a $50 fee for the makeup class. If you miss more than one class, you will fail the term because only one makeup class is offered per term. As a new apprentice, you are in the probationary period. For the inside program, this is the first 2,000 on-the-job training hours or your first 2 terms of school, whichever comes first. For the limited energy program, this is the first 1,500 on-the-job training hours or the first 2 terms of school, whichever comes first. The residential program, this is the first 1,000 hours or the first term of school, whichever comes first. If you fail a class during your probationary period, you will be canceled from the program and you will need to reapply. If you fail a term once you are beyond your probationary period, you will need to retake the class at your own expense, and your next wage increase will be postponed until you complete the next term. If you fail two terms, you will be canceled from the program and will need to reapply. When you are attending school, you will have homework assignments which will require anywhere from 2 to 10 hours of time per week, depending on the class and your aptitude. Homework is online, as well as your work progress reports, so you will need reliable access to a computer and internet connection. Before you race in here and apply, you want to be sure that you are at your best. Build a strong portfolio highlighting your work experience and education. As far as what we look for on your transcripts, we do a lot of math. During the basic skills class in those first 2 weeks, we'll be doing trigonometry on the board, making calculations, and then applying it in the conduit lab, bending conduit. We also use a lot of algebra formulas, so you need to be strong in math. The math requirements are a minimum. We don't necessarily teach math. We teach electrical theory, which involves a lot of math. Industry-related classes are also great to show on your transcripts. If you have never built anything, if you have never used a saw or a hammer or a tape measure, find an industry-related class at a community college or think about doing a pre-apprenticeship program. The best way to get work experience is to work for an electrical contractor. To do electrical work, you need to either be a registered apprentice or a journeyman. But there are jobs within the industry called material handling jobs. Material handlers deliver, haul, and sort materials as well as clean up job sites. There are lighting maintenance jobs where you would go into a school or an office building and replace light bulbs. These types of jobs are in the industry. You'd be working for an electrical contractor, and if you're a good employee, they will probably write you a letter of recommendation. And that is very valuable. If one of our contractors writes a letter and says that they would be glad to hire you as an apprentice, that's one of the best things you can bring to the table. If you can't find work in the electrical industry, something in the construction industry would be good, whether as a carpenter, a laborer, or a roofer, something that shows us that you can use some tools, maybe read a blueprint, work in all kinds of weather conditions, and work hard. Those are qualities that are important to us. This shows us that you are prepared for the hard work of an electrician. Your grooming and attire are going to make a huge impact on the interview committee. When you get to that interview, you have 10 minutes to show us why you are better than the next person. You need to be good at selling yourself, highlighting your experience and your capabilities. Practice interviewing. You may know inside that you're the best and that you can do anything that you set your mind to, but you need to be able to sell that to the interview committee. You need to be comfortable in an interview, and you need to be able to convince the committee that you are the best candidate. Punctuality is critical. If you are late, they may not interview you, and your application will be closed. Being on time is important every single day on the job and at school, and certainly at your interview. Application openings are posted at least 30 days in advance on our website and Facebook page. We take applications on an as-need basis rather than on a set schedule. Be sure to have your transcripts and application portfolio at the ready for when we do post an application opening. Thank you for taking the time to become informed about our apprenticeship programs.